Against a backdrop of high inflation, high borrowing costs, and a looming economic slowdown, we ask our next guest, is 2023 shaping up to be a fruitful year? Fruitas Director and Chief Financial Advisor Calvin Chua joins us live. Calvin, welcome back. Good to see you. Hi.
Good morning, Limi.
Good morning. So, Calvin, talk about where growth is going to come from now for Fruitas Holdings. I mean, Q1 earnings already beat pre-pandemic numbers. So what's next? Is it going to be, you know, is the next leg of growth going to be still same store sales, or is it going to be through M&As?
Yeah, our same store sales has been continuing to be very strong. But as you said, we had a few acquisitions last year, actually closed this year, and that will be a good contributor to growth as well. So specifically Lingnam, and we are looking at a few more opportunities this year.
Mm-hmm. A few more opportunities. How many more are in advanced stages of talks? And could you give us an idea? I'm sure you're not going to reveal the names, but an idea of more or less which companies or what kind of companies are you in talks with?
So when we launched the IPO of Balay, we had mentioned that we wanted to look at more value-added products. So that's certainly a segment that we are looking at. And for Fruitas, we have had a good opportunity or had a good experience in terms of the casual dining for Lingnam. So we're looking at other opportunities to bolster that segment as well.
Mm-hmm. And how many are in advanced stages as we speak?
Can't say at the moment, but yes, we are very busy, maybe, on in terms of evaluating these opportunities.
All right. Aside from Lingnam, you guys also bought recently 100% of a ghost kitchen called Fly Kitchen. What is the rationale for this? Does it mean that you're boosting big time your delivery service?
Correct. So even before the acquisition of Fly Kitchen, we had set up our own cloud kitchen venture called Nube Cocina third quarter of last year. So with this acquisition, we increased the number of facilities from 2 to 6, adding 200 square meters of kitchen space and 9 more brands, right? So we also see a lot of complement between these 9 new brands and our drinks, and maybe Lingnam will be part of the brands in those kitchen facilities as well soon.
Just very curious, since you mentioned, since we're on the discussion of ghost kitchens, could you give us a sense how much of your sales are still in-person stores versus sales that go through, you know, delivery?
We are pushing towards the 20% mark in terms of e-commerce sales, and that's both our in-store delivery as well as through third-party aggregators. With the acquisition of Light Kitchen, we hope to push that further.
Mm-hmm. All right. Calvin, I want to ask you about valuations. I'm trying to do the math because your income for the first quarter of this year is at 19.2 million pesos. And you've got over 800 stores at the moment. I know it's too simplistic to do this, but 19.2 million divided by 800 comes out to roughly 24,000 pesos net income per store for 3 months. Is that the usual? Is that the going income for kiosks these days? Or would you say there are a significant number of stores that are not making money and a number of stores from your network that are really having blockbuster sales?
It's a combination, but I would say the ones which are generating a lot more sales and have improved versus pre-pandemic levels are a significant majority. There are still a number of stores which are in the recovery mode, but overall we are very happy with our current slate. And in fact, we've added net number of about 50 in the first half. and hopefully another 50 within the year and
Wow.
within the second half of the year.
All right.
In terms of profitability, as you said at the start of the interview, right? There's a number of headwinds still facing us in terms of inflation. But as they subside, we are confident that the base that we are starting from with the increased productivity efficiency would serve us well.
I was going to get to that for my next question. What are you thinking in terms of scenarios? I mean, we've been getting softer CPI numbers for 5 months already. Does it change anything for your growth projections this year and maybe expansion plans, making you a little bit bolder?
We are targeting at least 30% revenue growth this year, but we see further upside if our expansion plans are can be implemented faster. In terms of what we are looking after, of course, there was a recent wage increase implemented that would have an impact on our bottom line, but hopefully this will also redound to increased productivity for our employees.
All right. And let's talk about the consumer. We're seeing a seismic shift in how people are consuming and are eating, drinking today. I mean, Calvin, when you look maybe 5, 10 years from now, how is how I get my juice fix or my dim sum noodle fix or my pandesal fix going to be different in a few years? Or is it going, how is the consumption going to change?
If you look at the current generation, they
That's
want
us,
everything.
right?
Yes, I'm part of that, and
Okay.
you too. They want everything fast, well, I'm looking 5 years from now, right? So maybe some AI technology, which I think is already implemented in a few countries, right? So even before you order, they would probably know what's in your mind, right? That's part of the algorithms already in some of the third-party aggregators. I still see though that loyalty will be a large part of it, and that's why we are not forgetting, how we take care of our customers. I think customer experience will still be key, despite of everything else, despite of technology. So, customer experience plus technology, to those who will get that right, will be the leaders in the future.
So why don't you talk to us a little bit more about the innovation and growth strategy that Frutas Holdings is implementing over the next 5 to 10 years? You briefly mentioned about artificial intelligence. Are there any other innovations that you're looking to get on board?
In terms of innovation, I think what we are looking at is more automation of our processes in the back room. We to free up a lot of our resources there and therefore use that towards serving our clients. Our clients, I would say, well, in general, right, have evolving tastes. So being able to detect that quite easily or quite fast should be top of mind, right? So we won't change our strategy of having a lot more own stores on the ground because that will give us a pulse in terms of what they want.
And you talked about expansion. You're looking to open another 50 for the second half of this year. Are you not worried that, we're already starting to feel saturated with food and beverage, and kiosk brands?
We are not. In fact, if we hear what the plans are of our competitors, they're even more aggressive. We continue to take the stance of a more disciplined approach. There are continuing influx of new brands, but I would say the success rate of those is still small, right? We believe in the strength of our brands and that our brands provide value for money. Mm-hmm. So we will continue to invest in our brands and you know, emphasize the value to our customers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And speaking of your brands, you currently have how many brands?
We're pushing probably to 40 with additional brands from Fly Kitchen. Uh-huh. But the brands from Frutas will probably be around 25.
Yeah, you've got Frutas, Jamaican, Buco Loco, the Mango Farm, Halo Halo, Le Village, Soy and Bean, Bobot's Farm. Exciting times ahead. How many new brands are you looking to bring over the next 6 to 12 months?
Probably at least 3 to 5 brands. Mm-hmm. Depends on how the discussions on M&A opportunities pan out. But as you know, this is an evolving thing. Mm-hmm. So if there are brands which we think need to be replaced, we will do that. We are not necessarily married to all of our brands, and they're only as good as the value that they bring to the customers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Good to know. Okay, exciting times ahead. Calvin, we look forward to learning more about these brands that you're bringing in. Thank you so much for joining us, and see you soon.
Thank you.
All right.